Henry and Robin.
Hello, dear friends, everybody, ladies and gentlemen. It's very nice to see everybody here. And there seems to be a preponderance of older retired friends, including Henry and Bob. It's always very difficult to know what to say in these circumstances, whether it's to be the praise or something else about our retiring colleagues. When I was asked to say a few words, I thought of all the things I could say about them.
It's all been said.
That's exactly what
they told me. Great things to mention about Bob and Henry, such as the dedication that Henry has given to this service and to us over the years. And I know it's all been said before, Henry, but we owe you a great debt. Yeah. And you've always been a very keen political with a small p animal. And your point of view have been carried on for many, many years. And it must have been very soon after you were licensed that you became involved with Bison's politics. Wasn't it?
Yeah, about 2 years.
Because I can remember in Gravesend at London Pilots Council, which were terribly boring meetings, with this young whiz kid from the Medway was telling everybody what to do in the end. Peter came along, didn't you, to talk about the airport, the Maplin development, from one of the meetings. All right. And of course, with Bob, we have a different kettle of fish. He's upholding a great pioneer tradition. He's not going to listen to me.
I was watching all their faces.
Which is being carried on, of course, by Robin. And I suspect that the Lileys and the Cartons actually planted some of the Roman galleys when they came all those years ago. And we'd be quite keen to do it again, I suspect. I could talk about Bob's prowess as a cricketer, which I won't. Well, Henry's a golfer, which is suspect, I believe.
Very, very.
I feel that today we should speak from the heart and remember Bob and Peachy and Henry and Pauline as they are, and they always will be, as our friends. And I think that's the important thing, that we are friends and we all, apart from working together. And Henry will now be able to negotiate a different kind of life. Divorce from the tensions of the telephone and the joys of Bob, ships that pass in the night. We only ever get to see each other at night, isn't it? This morning, I received a letter from a fellow Cape Horner in Finland, which included a poem which is a little bit trite, I thought, but I thought I'd read a bit of it to you, because it's relative to ageing and retiring, and we're all going that way, aren't we, eventually. But I'll read you a piece of this poem just to keep us up to date. And it starts by saying that remember and follow, as well as you can, the rules for the aged, for women, woman or man. Stay alive all your life. I say this to myself, quoting a book on my bedside shelf. Keep yourself busy and use every day in a positive, sensible sort of way. No dismal self-pity, no senseless repining, and let only solitude witness your whining. The demon depression, that horrible wraith, can be kept in abeyance with humour and faith. If you want to be liked, and who doesn't want that, it's best to keep problems right under your hat. And this is important, be ready to cheer just anyone needing a listening ear. Then I'd say, well, good luck, all the best, have a go. And how you get on, I'd be happy to know. And that is written by a Finnish gentleman, translated into English by himself, and I thought it was quite apt in a way. And Henry and Pauline, I wish them a long and happy retirement.
Henry.
We have someone here for you both.
It's about his teeth, I think.
Henry? It's not a bomb.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
May I have your attention just a little minute? First of all, I'd like to thank you all for coming here, which I'm very, very pleased to see such a great number of you. All my old friends, and they are old friends too. And I want to thank the pilots, the pilots and their tradition for giving us this send-off and for the present, which is a clock. I will open up in a minute when I have a few spare moments, and to thank you very much for that. It is to my requirement, to my, they asked me what I wanted, and that was it, and it's a beautiful piece of machinery there. The other thing I would like to say is thank you to Paulie for all the time that she has given to listening to my voyage up and down the Black Deep, Prince's Channel, the old Harwich Harbour, all these places that we have to know, and which she had to sit down and listen to, which must have been tremendously boring. It was to me, but I had to do it. Pauline did it voluntarily. But she did all that, and then when I got licensed, she started driving cars, middle of the night, up and down the Thanet Way, which she hated with a great hate. I can't say I'll blame her. She did all that for me, and then when I became involved in the politics with a small team, she put up with my sort of late nights and meetings up in London with Greenfield and who are the others around here? Yeah. Martin Lee was right. One of them, and Bob Liley should have been here. He's another part of the great piloting family of the Lileys, but he phoned up this morning and made his apologies.
Colin Lyle.
But, you know, I spent a lot of time away from home, and when I came home, I was very, very uptight, I suppose, because things don't always go the way you want them to go. And, of course, nearest person to... No, they don't, you all know. And the nearest person, you know, got the brunt of it. So Pauline was very good, and she put up with all that. And I say thank you very much for it.
Yeah, yeah.
And the other things I've got to say is for the people who are not pilots, but have also come here and have been very, very good to me over the years. And that's Peter Taylor, who's... Mm. Where's Peter? There he is. Peter Taylor, who looked after our affairs when we were self-employed, kept us supplied with very good advice and more or less on the straight and narrow for a very low remuneration, I would say. But he very, very kind of him to come. And of course, Jeff Baskerville there, hiding a little bit in the background. Mm. He was a good friend to us, I think. I certainly think so. Got on very well with them. Unfortunately, in the days of the transfer, we had to take, not opposing sides exactly, but we both had different jobs to do. But I think we did them very well, Jeff. And we came out of it okay.
No, we could see each other's point of view.
No scars. So there's that. And who else have we got here? Well, my friend Peter Bones over in the corner here. They're probably wondering, what's the farmer got to do with it all? Well, he's got a lot to do with it. He lets me play golf in his field for a start. And he's been a very, very good and constant friend over many, many years. Never let me win the 200 club, but we'll forgive him for that. But thanks for coming anyway, Peter.
Thank you. My pleasure.
And let me see, what else have I got to say before we... Let me get on with everything else. Yeah, the other thing is, of course, the committee who do this. Now, until the changeover came in 1988, we'd never really had a sort of an entertainment committee. Our friend, unfortunately not with us anymore, Bill Cuttle, he, I think, was the last entertainment officer we had. And very sorry Bill is not here, but the new pilots who came in, one of the first things they did was Trevor Lee, John Gurton, they set up a social committee. And I thank you for arranging this for me, and if I may say it for you also, Bob, thank you very much for your efforts. Thank you. Celebrating his retirement today. John McKeen, if you would like to come forward, we will make your gift.
Well, what are you going to give me, Henry?
We're going to give you a golden hat.
It's so beautifully rested.
Well,
chap, George Button, a lot of you probably know him. And I told him approximately what I wanted, and this is what he turned out with. Now this, if you can see it properly, is what we see when we're coming into the Medway Channel. It's the rough course of where we would be at that time. But the odd thing about it was, 2 weeks ago I took a ship into Whitstable Dock, and in the dock was this white barge making a terrible mess of things and running into everything. And I was told that he had just won the pin mill barge racing thing a couple of weeks ago. And when the artist painted this, I said to him, do you know the name of the barge? And he says, well, no, he says, I don't really. And I said, well, I think it's the one, because it's a metal barge, and it's the only one that's painted white, and it's called the Reminder. And what an apt thing, straight out of the blue, that thing should be called the Reminder. So that's going to remind me of many, many happy years with all of you. And I think, to me and to the other three that have just retired, the best thing about it is that we've got people like Howard, Gordon, John Greer, all the people that we've spent a long time with. Colin Rhodes, I can't mention you all, but they're all here. Even the people from the South Channel, you know, we used to think of them as being a little bit odd on the
Medway. I still do.
But it's been a wonderful life. I've thoroughly enjoyed it, and I suppose if I had my time over again, I'd do exactly the same thing. I would now like to thank so many people, but first I think I would like to thank my wife for putting up all these awkward hours. When you think about it, you know, the phone rings, we get out of bed, but the wives are wakened up, everybody's wakened up, the whole house is wakened up, and she's put up with this as all the wives have done, and all the wives will do. There's so many here don't realize how many years they've got. I would like to thank all the retired pilots for coming. I'm now going to join them every first Wednesday. Isn't it going to be lovely? The bar will be awash with shipping and waves will be going over the bar. But I think I would really like to thank the boatmen for coming along. It's never really been said on the Medway how much we've owed to the boatmen. They've looked after us. They drove our cars. They took us everywhere we wanted to go, and in at least one occasion, pulled one of us out of the water. Yeah. He's not here today, he's on holiday, Ken Lintoff, but Charlie fished him out of the water, and we tend to forget the amount of work that our boatmen have put in, especially on the Medway, because we consider them on the Medway, and this is with no disrespect to Ted, and all the South Shadow. No disrespect at all. But we had something special with our boatmen on the Medway, and we looked after them, and they looked after us. And I was very, very pleased that they managed to come along today to see the four of us go. And, you know, thank you very much. And he wouldn't be here for this do, you see, but he tells me now he came back specially.
And it's very nice to have all you pilots on board with us.
We've also got his deputy, who was one of us for a wee while. And we've got Ken Richmond. Very nice. He's still here. How long have you been up in the tower, Ken?
Oh, a few years now. Just a few years.
So, without any more ado, I'd like to thank you all for a wonderful life. This is on behalf of all of us, not just me, all the pilots who retired. You've given us a wonderful life. We've thoroughly enjoyed it, and we hope to see you when you retire on the first Wednesday of every month. Ladies and gentlemen,
wait,
colleagues. Okay. You just shut up. so retirement finished. But now, I heard David say how much we, the Medway pilots, or all pilots, owe to those pilots who spend their lives on committees. And there is nobody who has spent as much time on committees as... that you can see for the last time that he is actually shorter than me. And when he came here as a tripper, I thought, isn't it wonderful? Because there was only me and Raymond Vallings, who was the real snow. Where's Raymond? But like everything else, all the good things come in small parcels. And Henry has been on our committee. He's worked and worked and worked. He's really slaved and slaved, and I think done himself a lot of medical injury. I think he did too much. But he's soldiered through, he's looked after us. And when you think of the period that we went through from being self-employed to being as you are now, the amount of hours that this man put in, is out of this world. I don't suppose anybody will realise how much he did, apart from his wife. And she's keeping herself very quiet. So, Henry, on behalf of the pilots, my last official pleasure is to present you with this envelope. There may be something in it. I just want to give you the envelope. And I've been told that you're going to put this envelope to very good use. Something to do with your computer, isn't
that right?
So even in retirement, he's going to be working. Isn't this wonderful? A good hand. Yeah.
First of all, I've got one other duty to discharge, and that is to thank the ladies, the wives, and to present them with their bouquets. And I was going to do what you already have done for me, is to mention specially for all the work that they put in to keeping us afloat, if you like. They are the ones who, as John said, stay at home, worry about us going out, put up with the phone calls, the terrible hours that we work at times, and they can never arrange their lives around us. And at the end of it all, the men come up here and they get the gifties. They get the little presentals and the wives get a bouquet. Well, that's the way it is. And maybe it's not. The new wives now to put the pressure on and maybe change it round. But ladies, can we please have Anne McKeen to come forward? And we have for Anne. Pleased to have been able to do whatever I have done. Not everyone has been pleased with it, and I've not been all that pleased with it myself. But I have tried. That's all I can say. And I think we've done all right. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention one moment, please. At rather short notice, I've been asked to address the assembly here, which is convened to convey to Jeff Baskerville, just retired harbour master of the Medway Port Authority, our esteem for him and our good offices for his retirement, our well wishes for his retirement. Now, it's a short notice speech. I don't intend to keep you here very long. But Jeffrey has been a friend of ours for many, many years. He was already with the port when I came here, which was 25 years ago, and I think about 28 years here, is it, Jeff? 27 years. And in the early part of that time, Jeff, I don't think, had an awful lot to do with the pilots. But he certainly looked after our interests, even then, because when I came here first, and I had a little problem in Rochester, and I asked for help, Jeffrey was the man who came. And he was very good to the pilots, understood our problems, and did everything he could to help us. And that didn't change through all the years. He receded into the background as far as pilots were concerned, now and again. But latterly, when he became deputy, he was very much in the forefront of pilotage affairs from the point of view of the port. But in all that time when we had our dealings with him, we sat on opposite sides of a table, but we knew that in Jeffrey we were dealing with an honest man. And that was saying something in those times. But that was then, and later on, when the ports took over pilotage and Jeffrey became harbour master, he then was, I wouldn't say a friend of the pilots, he was a friend of the pilots, but he had a job to do. And he did his job, and he looked after our interests as well, because he understood them. Jeffrey, above all, was a seaman, and he understood the pilot's point of view, and in fact, in part of his career, he was actually a pilot in Kuwait, I believe, wasn't it, Jeff? For some time. So he did understand us, and I hope that we understood him, and didn't give him too hard a time, because we tend to do that with people on the other side of our particular fence. But anyway, in all those years, Jeff has been, I think, our friend, and certainly we respected him, no matter what particular differences we might have had, and we have them with everybody at times because of our particular profession. But Jeff was always there, always an honest man for us, and as far as I'm concerned, he was always a good friend to pilots. And to mark our esteem for him, and for the many years which we have had the pleasure of his company, we have made a small token up. And this is a silver coaster, suitably inscribed. And for you, Jeff, thank you very much.
Thank you
very much.
Wish
you a very happy return.
Thank you.
And the gallery, we have, because we can't forget the ladies. I did the last time I had to make some speeches, or nearly did. But there you are, Valerie. Thank you for looking after him for us.
Thank you.
I hope you continue to do so.
I will, promise. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed.
Of course, you want me to stand here now.
You can have a go now.
I had less time than you, in fact, to prepare it, because I knew nothing about this until 8 o'clock this morning, and my wife said, well, will you be ready for about 12:15? She said, I'm taking you out to lunch. I thought, well, that's the best indication ever. And how nice it is, actually, to, if you like, attend here and see a lot of faces which have been with me for many, many years. As Henry said, 27 years, I know a lot of you can chalk up much better records than that, but nevertheless, they were 27 happy, adventurous, exciting years, and I think all of us have seen terrific changes on the Medway. Fortunately, I think we've always progressed, although I'm sure one or two will, in fact, disagree with me, possibly around 1988, but nevertheless, change is a fact of life. I think it's what is so warming today is to be among one's contemporaries. You were not colleagues of mine in actual essence, but you have always been contemporaries of mine. I've always had a very healthy respect for the pilots. I think that you did a marvellous job on the river. When you look at the accident figures for the Medway, they really are, they're virtually non-existent. And there's very few rivers and harbours, I would suggest, certainly in Northwest Europe, can boast that sort of thing. And I believe that rests with the professionalism of the pilots. I really am very, very touched today. I don't know whether I'm the first harbour master which has ever been presented with something by the pilots.
Presented with something like this. Anyway.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much, both for attending and both for your well wishes to Valerie and I. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well, I always say.
Can you read what it says, Geoffrey, please? Captain Geoffrey Baskerville, Harbour Master.
Remember Sheerness?
Yes. Got Henry.
Did you say with your glasses? Because it's a bit.
Oh, sorry, Sheerness Harbour Master, 1992, Medway Pike.
Chairman, secretary, dog's body, did everything, I think, has done a whole gamut of helping the Medway pilots in their need. And when we were taken over by that company up the road, Stan became our treasurer and probably had as much problems as he did before, even though we were being employed. But he still was treasurer to the association. And in appreciation of his long hard work.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
To make a speech or to invite others to say thank you so much for your appreciation of this and to wish all success to my successors, I'm all the phrase. John Gurton now taking over from it. I've enjoyed, I think, a great deal being involved in parliament, not only from the actual physical aspect of the job itself, but also the admin side of it. Adds dimension, a lot of interest, which I recommend to all our young people coming in. Get involved in the draw. It's a much more satisfying way to do it. Thank you very much, and good luck to my success.
All of us to say a lot of happy retirement to Ted. And may I, first of all, before we say a few words, say we've received a couple of messages for Ted. And the first one is from Alfredo. Lawyer of Frio Goss. And the message says, have a long and happy retirement, Mr. Farmer. From Alfredo on the Arroyo Frio Goss. Also, please pass on my regards to all my old friends at the Medway. That, from a Spaniard, is something. He wouldn't be pushed to be here if he couldn't wait, but unfortunately, he hasn't come in for long enough for him to visit us. There's also another message from the Ramsgate Cutters. All the very best from Keith Pope and all your friends on the Ramsgate Cutters. Drop in and visit us someday. When we're above the amusement arcade. Perhaps a joke shop would have been more fitting for ESL.
Okay.
Right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, as I said earlier, we now come to the little chat about Ted and all he has done, and we're so pleased he's managed to retire. I think he's one of the few pilots I know who perhaps didn't want to retire. Most of us are trying to get out early, but Ted, bless his soul, didn't go to the very last day. He did actually get some leave and knock off before Christmas, because officially he could retire on the 26th or 27th of December. Anyway. You're looking very fit
already. Thanks very much.
I'm glad to see you. Retirement is doing you well. But just to go back to a little brief history, as I say, I only knew I was leaving last night. Martin Lee had made a few notes, which I'm afraid I can hardly read. But to go back to Blake, I understand that you started as a Blue Funnel.
That's correct. Yeah.
Spent all your time with Blue Funnel. And then became a pilot in 1962, in November 62.
After Bluey.
Yes. Well, there's a little comment that in the days when you came in, I think there were many, many, many Blue Funnel pilots.
That's right.
People who have been in Blue Funnel, and companies like Royal Mail, New Zealand Company, PMO. Today they all disappeared. But our pilots come from Deerbolt, you know, ferries. Ferries, Marks. No disrespect, but we, you know, the old companies have just gone, and Ted and the one two of us are the last in a long line, I suspect, of these companies. Anyway, Ted did the full span as a pilot. He was well known. His voice was always well known on the radio. Ted, first of all, when he was a St. Paul's pilot. We as Medway pilots used to only see them in a few fleeting moments as they brought the ship into Garrison Point, and having got a car carrier, you know, spent 5 minutes getting to the bridge, unable to say anything but goodbye Ted as he runs off. And by the time you've got your breath back, you're alongside the berth. But Ted, meanwhile, had spent all the night waiting in the anchorage or wherever to let us have a nice peaceful rest. Those days are gone. He came in 1988 to join us when the new Medway ports took over, the new pilotage, along with some of his